Celebrate the sacred mysteries. The contrite of hearts, sing
Christ have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Might God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere love and love your holy name, for you never deprive of your guidance to those you set firm on the foundation of your love. Grant the prayers that we seek before you in this Mass, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The king of Babylon brought captive to Babylon Jehoiakim and all the men of valor. A reading from the second book of Kings. Jehoiakim was 18 years old when he became king, and he reigned 3 months in Jerusalem. His mother's name was Nehushta, the daughter of Elnathan of Jerusalem, and he did what was evil in the sight of the Lord, according to all that his father had done. At that time, the servants of Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, came up to Jerusalem, and the city was besieged. And servants were besieging it, and Jehoiakim, the king of Judah, gave himself up to the king of Babylon himself, and his mother, and his servants, and his princes, and his palace officials. The king of Babylon took him prisoner in the 8th year of his reign, and carried off all the treasures of the house of the Lord, and the treasures of the king's house, and cut in pieces all the vessels of gold in the temple of the Lord, which Solomon, king of Israel, had heard all the had made as the Lord had foretold. He carried away all Jerusalem and all the princes and all the mighty men of valor, 10,000 captives and all the craftsmen and the smith. None remained except the poorest people of the land. And he carried away Jehoiakim to Babylon, the king's mother, the king's wives, his officials, and the chief men of the land. He took into captivity from Jerusalem to Babylon. And the king of Babylon brought captive to Babylon all the men of Vera, 7,000, and the craftsmen, and the smith, 1,000, all of them strong and fit for war. And the king of Babylon made Matania, Joachim's uncle, king in his stead, and changed his name to Zedekiah. The word of the Lord. Response. For the sake of the glory of your name, free us, O Lord.
For the sake of the glory of your name, free us, O Lord.
For the sake of the glory of your name, free us, O Lord.
For the sake of the glory of your name, free us, O Lord.
O God, the nations have invaded your heritage. They have profaned your holy temple. They have made Jerusalem a heap of ruins. They have handed over the bodies of your servants as food to feed the birds of heaven and the flesh of your faithful to the beasts of the earth. For the sake of the glory of your name, pray us, O Lord. They have poured down to their blood like water around Jerusalem. No one is left to bury the dead. We have become the taunt of our neighbors, the mockery and scorn of those around us. How long, O Lord, will you be angry forever? Will your jealous anger burn like fire? For the sake of the glory of your name, pray us, O Lord. Do not remember against us the guilt of former times. Let your compassion hasten to meet us, for we have been brought very low. For the sake of the glory of your name, pray us, O Lord. Help us, O God, our Savior, for the sake of the glory of your name. Free us and forgive us our sins because of your name.
For the sake of the glory of your name, free us, O Lord.
Alleluia.
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 Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Me, he will keep my word, says the Lord, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him.
Alleluia,
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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, "Not everyone who says to me, 'Lord, Lord,' shall enter the kingdom of heaven, but he who does the will of my Father who is in heaven. On that day, many will say to me, 'Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy in your name, and cast out demons in your name, and do many mighty works in your name?' And then will I declare to them, 'I never knew you. Depart from me, you evildoers.' Everyone then who hears the words of mine and does them will be like a wise man who built his house upon the rock. and the rain fell, and the floods came, and the winds blew and beat upon that house, but it did not fall, because it had been founded on the rock. And everyone who hears these words of mine and does not do them will be like a foolish man who built his house upon the sand. And the rain fell, and the floods came, and the winds blew and beat against that house, and it fell, and great was the fall of it. And when Jesus finished these sayings, the crowds were astonished at his teaching, for he taught them as one who had authority, and not as their scribes. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Jesus Christ.
I'd like us to reflect on the theme, believe first in the Lord, then confess him as Lord. Believe first in the Lord, then confess him as Lord. Christianity is not a profession, but a genuine practice. It's not like, you know, you go to classroom and study accounts, you study being a teacher or whatsoever. It's a genuine practice, a way of life, a style of life that is founded and sustained in Christ alone. That's even where the name comes from, Christian, based on Christ, founded on Christ. It is not a lip service to God and neighbor. It is a very radical kind of life, and sometimes quite misunderstood by many of us. And yet it has only two necessary and very important principles. Love God. Love your neighbor. Full stop. These are the ones to be highly qualified and developed in this lifestyle, in this way of life, Christianity. In today's gospel, Jesus sternly warns us that not everyone that calls him Lord, Lord will enter the kingdom of heaven, not at all. I don't know how we might feel about this or think about this, but it poses so many questions to us. Is Jesus dismissing the prayers that we do while calling him by that title? Is he making us so useless before him in our prayers? Is Jesus mocking us by some sort of insolence? These might be very tough questions for all of us to think of their answers, especially with regard to this gospel text which we have had today. What does Jesus think of those seeking him that turn to him for a favor? As we begin our prayer, Lord Jesus, please, even today when we began our Mass, I invited you to, you know, offer your prayers. And I'm kind of sure that you began like, Lord Jesus, I pray for this in this Mass. What does Jesus think of those in joy and yet turn to him in thanksgiving? Lord, I thank you. Really, do you hear me say, Master, I thank you, but Lord. What does he think of those in desolation and yet turn to him for consolation? Because they begin their prayer, Lord, have mercy on me. I'm so deprived. I'm so afflicted. Please console me. What does he think of those that are confused and yet they turn to him for guidance and direction. Because they turned to him, Lord, I'm really confused. Which way should I take? What is the light? Where is the star? Is this really a waste for us who begin our prayers with him? In him, Lord Jesus, I doubt it shouldn't be so. Christ demands from us today a genuineness of heart, from each one of us, to connect the mind and the heart in our invocations towards him. The mind and the heart. The mind's reason, but the heart's belief. Then, who are those that will enter the kingdom of heaven? That will be useful, that will be accepted, and therefore beneficial to the life of God. My dear brothers and sisters, it is those that believe in order to confess the real power they have experienced in the meaning of Jesus as Lord. So then, believe in him and then confess him in the midst of others. Prophecy, as mentioned in the Gospel, exorcisms and deliverances in Jesus' name are only real for the believer as realities of faith, not reason. So then, believe first, then confess what you believe.
Stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. By the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given out for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." We proclaim your death, O Lord,
and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memory of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring out the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. Listen to our prayer. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs with eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the name of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Father who art in heaven,
hallowed be your name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of us, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And
let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my roof, but I only say a word, and my soul shall be
us pray. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption. This is our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Hear me, God.